Hello guys, my name is Daniel Rincón. I am an electromechanical engineer. I am doing my master's study at the Federal University of Uberlandia. I am going to share a presentation entitled Experimental Evaluation of Electrolytic Performance into an Alkaline Fuel Cells. Fossil fuels have remained for long times as the first option to satisfy energy demand worldwide, mainly due to the great variety of derivatives that could be obtained from it. However, different studies have demonstrated that this is a advantage of the long-term use of fossil fuels as non-renewable energy source. There are limited and highly polluting generates demand to the environment and human health. The Montreal Protocol and the European Union have made restrictions and the appropriate regulation to mitigate emission of particulate matter, dioxide, and carbon monoxide. With this, it seeks to gradually decrease the use of conventional energy sources to meet energy demand, because, for example, from oil derivatives are obtained that in the medium or long term end up being pollutants. In this sense, process with efficient energy generation based on alternative energy sources has turned of great importance in a sense, file especially in development of new fuels. There are several types of fuel cell, among which are the DMC, PPAF, MCFC, soft, and the versatility of fuel cell can be measured according to the research carried on them and their impact or applicability in the industry according to the power they supply. Their availability is identified in transport system, mobile, or stationary system. In this article, the validator with experimental data of an AFC type electrolytic cell that produces hydrogen as an alternative fuel cell be carrying out each sensor used to obtain the experimental data will be described. The device that constitutes the electrolysis test pins will be identified and the cell temperature and flow data. Experimental process. The production of hydrogen gas is possible due to the electrolysis process of the water present inside the cell when an electrical work is supplied. Take place an electrochemical reaction that model the decomposition of the water molecule. The main components of the test bench are as follows: reservoir, electrolytic cell, power supply, bubbler, current measure. Additionality, the temperature of electrochemical reaction in electrolytic cell was measured using LM35. The measure was performed by putting the sensor in contact with a positive plate that leads to the anode and another on a negative plate that leads to the cathode to observe the variation in each electrode. To understand how the electrolytic cell producer oxidation gas as a result the electrolysis of water. A flow chart of the electrolysis operation is proposed with each of the elements that influence the process. The electrolytic cell to perform the validation of the temperature and flow of the fuel cell are sodium bicarbonate and potassium hydroxide. Sodium bicarbonate, a chemical substance, is commercially accessible. For this reason, it is considered in this research. Potassium hydroxide, it is the electrolyte most mentioned in literature work. Experimental validation of the fuel cells. The experimental test on the electrolytic alkaline cell was carried out at different concentration of bicarbonate sodium as hydroxide potassium to analyze the effect of the energy supply by the electrolyte on the electrochemical reaction. The figure shows the changes in cell temperature with respect to time for different concentration for concentration of bicarbonate sodium. The figure shows the variation of reaching temperature with respect to time for different concentration of potassium hydroxide. The figure shows the oxidation gas production flow rate in the electrolysis with different concentration of bicarbonate sodium. Increasing the amount of sodium bicarbonate leads to high increase in the flow rate, reaching a maximum value of 0.29 milliliters seconds. The variation of the oxidation gas flow rate in the cells with different potassium hydroxide can be observed where the maximum oxidation gas production reaches a flow rate of 0.390 milliliters per second for the maximum potassium hydroxide concentration. The effect of the calorific potential of the electrolyte is also reflected in the oxidation gas flow of the cells with 6 grams of potassium hydroxide producing more flux than 20 grams of the sodium bicarbonate. Conclusions. In this work, an experimental investigation intended to determine which is the most favorable electrolyte in the operation of an alkaline fuel cell was carried out using two electrolytes, potassium hydroxide and sodium bicarbonate. Hence, from the experimental results obtained, the next can be concluded. The experimental data of cell temperature and oxidation gas flow rate allow observe the effect of the calorific potential of the electrolytes. In this sense, it was evidenced that the high energy contribution in the electrochemical reaction is proved by the potassium hydroxide with a temperature value of 42.20 degrees Celsius and flow 0.393 milliliters seconds. The analysis variables show to the directly proportional to concentration of the electrolyte That is, as the amount of electricity was increased, both cell temperature and oxygen fluoride increases. What verified that the obtained results are according to the literature. MechiLab affirmed that with potassium hydroxide, the temperature reach high values and the oxygen flow increase, making it the most suitable electrolyte for AFC. Finally, the most important reference of research are present. Thanks to Hals, the research will start this video and to NSIT organization. Thank you.